Luis, I'm so happy to meet you again. I don't know if you recall, we met last
And
time.
that's what I was thinking.
I hope to see you again soon, face to face in Jeddah. I'm so happy that you're coming to my home country. You know, I'm a big fan of F1. I've traveled around the world to just watch F1 and watch you guys racing and cheer for you. So honored that this year we're gonna host F1 finally in Saudi Arabia. How do you feel about that?
I'm excited because I've only ever seen images of Saudi online, but just I've had some friends that have gone out there and shown me some beautiful the desert and the huge amazing rock mounds that they have out there. So I know that whilst this time I'm probably not going to get out to that desert, but just to be in a new place, I'm definitely super excited. And I've been on the simulator on the track, so it's very fast.
I was about to ask you, what's your opinion on the new racetrack?
Yeah,
And
I mean, from the simulator, it's obviously the track's only, I think, just been finished. So there's definitely things that are missing, but the layout is very, very fast. It's going to be hugely,
yes.
massively challenging. And all the corners are blind, a bit like Monaco. So you arrive at corners and you can't see around the corner. So it's going to be a huge challenge for everyone.
But I believe this is an advantage for Mercedes, right? Because we have fast straight lines and fast corners. Does this give you more advantage?
It's really difficult to say whether it's an advantage because all year long we have gone to places where they're like, okay, we should be quick here, and then it's not the case. So I don't like to preempt what it's going to be like. We have long straights, we should be good on straights. But
Yes.
as I said, it could, if you know, depending how bumpy it is, depending if you're having to use all the curbs.
Sure.
Could change all of that. So we'll find out when we get there.
Because I was physically there while they are doing the track. So I noticed something, but of course, from your point of view, it's going to be different. What do you think specifically of turn 13? Because with the big slope, I think it's around 18 degrees, slope 70 to 18 degrees.
13.
Yeah, the
Yeah, the
big
big bank.
slope.
How banked is it?
Yes, I've never seen an F1 track for me, my personal opinion. They told me Red Bull has something close to that. But me personally, I've never seen any F1 track with this.
Yeah, the first time we've experienced that was this year in Zandvoort. Turn three in Zandvoort was really banked, and it was like a roller coaster ride through the banked curve. So on the simulator, it's not as banked as Zandvoort, but it's a really cool corner because you come down quite a relatively long straight, but then you can brake very deep, and then it increases, and then you feel the pressure, and then all of a sudden it spits you back out. So I think it's quite a cool corner because there's different lines I think you can take through there and maybe follow. So hopefully this is going to be a good track. It reminds me of like a new version of like Montreal,
Ah,
you know,
nice. I like
street vibe of Montreal, but obviously even faster because it's even more
even close to
straight.
the sea. By
Yeah.
the way, we have very nice beaches. If you have some room, you need to experience beaches in Jeddah. It's really
Really?
beautiful.
And the water is good? It's clear
Yes,
in there.
amazing. And if you like diving, the best sea view, if you are into diving.
Really?
The best. Yes. I would really
Interesting.
encourage you. Yeah. Another very important question. How do you feel about your new teammate, George Russell, for next year? Are you excited to have him joining you?
I think it's fresh. Yeah, it's going to be something new. So I think the team is excited. I think we've had an amazing run with Valtteri. And you know, George is the plan for the future. So him coming in, I think it's not like it's a brand new driver because he's driven for us before. He's been driven our car through practice before and on our sim. So he should gel in quite quick. And yeah, I mean, it's a new challenge to work with him, find a new way of working with him to develop a car for us to try and win the championship next year. So that is exciting for sure.
No, we're looking forward for that. And also, I'm very much looking forward for your last two races in Saudi and Abu
Me
Dhabi.
too.
And how close you think you are to the championship?
I've tried not to think about it, to be honest. I really have no idea what's going to happen in these next two races. Of course, I'm going with the mentality to win these two, just as I was really fortunate enough to do in the last two races. But a lot of that's about preparation, where we start with the car, if we can get the car to be optimum, you know, maximum performance there, like we've done in the last two races.
I'm wishing you the best of luck, and we're crossing fingers. You're a champion, and there's no wonder if you will get it, inshallah, again this year to 2021.
Thank you.
And now there's one thing, the past years, I remember myself when I'm watching F1, I'm cheering for F1. Most of the young generation around me, they look at me like, you don't watch soccer? The soccer was mostly here famous in Saudi or popular. The thing is now having Formula E, Dakar, and luckily F1, how do you feel that you are now inspiring the new generation in Saudi Arabia? And now they will understand what's motorsport, and now you will start having a bigger fan base from a new country that was quite a distance from, F1 specifically. So how is your feeling, and especially for young girls? Because, you know, I'm representing women, Saudi Arabia at the Women Motorsport Commission, and it's very important for us to inspire both young generations, from males and female. How do you feel about it?
Well, firstly, it's a difficult question, firstly, because we just went to Qatar, for example, and we had our first audience there. It wasn't massive, but similar to, I would say, a similar kind of size to maybe what we have in Bahrain, for example. I know that from just reading up, I know Saudis are a very, very young population, right?
Sure. More than 70% are below 30 years old.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. Where do all the old people go? It's incredible how young the place is. But also, I'm aware that, for example, women have only just been able to be out to drive on the road. So, how does that for young girls wanting to race? Are they allowed to, and are they encouraged by those changes now in order to be able to do that?
Lewis, you won't believe. For example, I'm head of women motorsport in Saudi. There are so many federations for different sports in Saudi. You won't believe that motorsport was the fastest accelerated sport for female.
Won't
believe. Yes, we did the first championship before even women started driving. Girls were ready, and they start racing karting. So really? I'm so happy. Last month we have a woman champion who won T4 and the Baja, the rally. Wow. I'm so proud. She just started last year, and now she's a world champion. So
I think I read about that. Yeah.
I'm so proud of her. I took her 2 years back for an experience in Dakar, and now look at her. She's a champion.
I would like to come to Dakar.
There's so much to catch up me and you regarding female and motorsport.
Absolutely.
But before we close this conversation, I want to teach a few Arabic words.
Can I just ask, what is the, how different is it to, you know, the language between Abu Dhabi and Qatar?
It's just the
different dialect. So
yes. So do you know any Arabic word?
No. I think the only one I know is Assalamu alaikum.
Perfect. You need this everywhere. Keep it in Riyadh and Jeddah. I mean, keep using it.
Okay.
The word that I wish for you is foz, which means victory, winning.
Foz.
So I wish you foz. Yeah, remember foz.
Foz
means winning.
Okay.
Victory. And number one is ragam wahid. So
but
I want to be number one in Jeddah.
But I'm number 44. How do you say 44?
40. Okay, I'll give you easy words. And the one nice word which I really wish for you is I want you to foz bil butula. It means win the championship.
Oh, but I want to know words like hi, how are you?
Ahlin, this is an easy word. Ahlin, or hala, hala.
Hala.
Hala is a very easy, yeah.
That's just hello?
Hi. Yeah, that's hi.
Hala, hala.
Yeah, and assalamu alaikum is more of a formal way of greeting.
Okay, and how do you say how are you?
Kif halak.
Kif halak.
Kif?
Halak. Hala, kif halak.
Yes, yeah, you're ready.
Yeah, those are, I think I can get by just with that.
Is ma'a salama.
Ma'a salama.
Yes.
Hala kif halak.
Yes.
The right, yeah. And what is the last one?
Ma'a salama.
Ma'a salama.
Yes.
Ma'a how do you say it?
Salama.
Salama.
Yes.
Oh God, it's pretty hard language.
I'm here to teach you. I'm in Jeddah. Whenever you need any assistance, I'm here.
You'll be there in the weekend though, right?
Sure, I'll be there. So I hope to see you again face to face, like we did in Abu Dhabi.
Yeah, me too. Make sure you come over and say hi.
And today is another honor, really.
Oh, no, that's so kind of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I hope I get to see you there. Make sure you come and say hi.
Thank you, Lewis, for today. So honored.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you,